Dylan Cormier scored 21 points and three other Greyhounds had 11 each as the Greyhounds cruised to an opening night victory in front of a sold-out Reitz Arena, defeating visiting Binghamton University 71-45 on Friday night. Before the game, head coach Jimmy Patsos and Loyola president Reverend Brian Lanane pulled the ropes to unveil the banner at the north end of Reitz Arena. The banner celebrates Loyola's 2012 NCAA tournament appearance. The largest student crowd ever to enter Reitz Arena for a Loyola men's basketball game was treated to a big victory by the Greyhounds. Loyola jumped out to a 39-22 halftime lead, propelled by a 19-0 run after Binghamton scored the opening points of the game. Binghamton scored on the first possession of the game, but then the Bearcats would not score again for over 10 minutes as Loyola went on a 19-0 run, capped by a Dylan Cormier three-pointer to make it 19-2 with just under 9.5 to play before halftime. Cormier had 13 at the break and the Greyhounds led by 17. The Bearcats got as close as 14 early in the second half. Jimmy Gray had a fast break layup at 17-25 and converted the ensuing free throw to make it 41-27. Loyola, however, scored 16 of the next 19 points. Julius Brooks capped it off with a layup at 10:30 and Loyola was up 27. Robert Olson and Tyler Hubbard each scored 11 points. Julius Brooks led the Greyhounds with 7 rebounds. During the game, the Metro Atlantic Athletic Conference preseason poll was announced. The Greyhounds were named the team to beat, edging out Manhattan for the top spot in the league poll. Eric Etherly, who scored 11 points and had 6 rebounds to go with 3 steals, was named the MAC preseason player of the year.
Dylan and Eric know what it's like to play in front of that home crowd because you don't always get that. Our student body's been tremendous. Really looking forward to coaching this team this season because I've said all along, I think we're going to get it better as we go.
Everything was set up for my teammates, you know, as the point guard now, stepping over, just getting to the hole and making plays is the key. But Bobby knocked down some early shots. We got Eric the ball inside off a post-up play isolation for him, and that just opened it up for me.
The Greyhounds are back in action with a quick trip to the Pacific time zone this weekend. They play on Sunday night at the University of Washington, a 5 o'clock Pacific, 8 o'clock Eastern game that can be seen on the Pac-12 network. They then return right here to Reitz Arena on Wednesday night, November the 14th, for a 9 p.m. game that'll be televised live on Masson, the Mid-Atlantic Sports Network, against crosstown rival UMBC. For complete details, log on to www.loyalagreyhounds.com.